This lesson explains three special cases of factoring. In a previous lesson, you learned the product of a sum and difference of the same terms is a difference of squares. For example, the product of x plus 3 and x minus 3 is x squared minus 3 squared, which is x squared minus 9. You can turn this around and factor a difference of squares. For example, w squared minus 25 is w squared minus 5 squared, which factors as w plus 5 times w minus 5. Here's an example of a difference of squares with two variables. 9x squared minus 16y squared is 3x squared minus 4y squared, which factors as 3x plus 4y times 3x minus 4y. This example reminds you of the first rule of factoring. Always look for GCF, the greatest common factor, first. For this binomial, begin by factoring out a GCF of 3x. This leaves x squared minus 4, which is x squared minus 2 squared. And the binomial factors as 3x times x plus 2 times x minus 2. Also, in a previous lesson, you learned about the shortcut for squaring a binomial. For example, to square x plus 2, square the first term, x squared, plus 2 times the product of the two terms, 2 times x times 2, plus the square of the second term, 2 squared, for x squared plus 4x plus 4. You can turn this around and factor perfect square trinomials. For example, if the first and last terms of a trinomial are perfect squares, it might be a perfect square trinomial. To find out, rewrite the first term as a square. Factor 2 from the second term, and rewrite the third term as a square. Now you can see the trinomial matches the pattern. Here's a squared, here's b squared, and here's 2ab. So a plus b has to be x plus 3. And the trinomial factors as x plus 3 squared. There's also a pattern for a minus b squared. For example, the first and last terms are perfect squares, so rewrite the first term as a square. Factor 2 from the second term, and rewrite the third term as a square. Now you can see it matches the pattern. Here's a squared, here's b squared, and here's 2ab. So a minus b must be x minus 5. And the trinomial factors as x minus 5 squared. Here's a trinomial that looks like a perfect square. The first and last terms are squares. However, when you rewrite the trinomial, the middle term is 2 times 5x, when it should be 2 times 4x to match the pattern. So this trinomial is not a perfect square. However, it does factor as x minus 2 times x minus 8. Since negative 2 and negative 8 are factors of plus 16 that add up to negative 10. Here's an example with two variables. The first and last terms are perfect squares. So rewrite the first term as a square. Factor 2 from the middle term and rewrite the third term as a square. Now you can see it matches the pattern. Here's a squared, here's b squared, and here's 2ab. So a plus b has to be 2x plus 3y. And the polynomial factors as 2x plus 3y squared. This lesson explained three special cases of factoring. And this lesson was brought to you by the Math Fun Academy, its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new math and new equations, to boldly go where no math student has gone before. Like California, yeah.